Welcome back to week four of the news. We've already been doing this for an entire month, which is fantastic. Today we have an excellent video for you guys because Ford just released the redesigned Ranger, and it has plenty of new options, plenty of new features, and it also looks fantastic. So let's just get right into this. Now, when I say redesigned Ranger, you have to understand that this is the Ranger, this body style is the Ranger that people in the United Kingdom and people in Mexico, pretty much everywhere else but us, has had for the last couple of years. So, not the end of the world, obviously. It looks fantastic. I can't wait to see them here on our lot. It is going to have a couple options for engines. It's going to have the 2.3 liter EcoBoost, the four-cylinder, or it's going to have the 2.7 liter EcoBoost, which is the big engine that you get in the Bronco. The 2.3 liter EcoBoost will have 270 horsepower with 310 pound-feet of torque, and the 2.7 liter V6 EcoBoost is shared with the F-150 and the Bronco, and that will produce 315 horsepower and 400 pound-feet of torque. Both of those are going to be mated to Ford's 10-speed select shift transmission, and obviously on the fly 4x4 shifting, which is super handy when you are on the move. Can't stop for anything these days. Now it looks like the absolute mad dogs at Ford Performance has put the 3-liter EcoBoost in the Ranger Raptor. That is the same engine that's in the Bronco Raptor. That's pretty bananas. So that's 400 horsepower, 430 pound-feet of torque, advanced four-wheel drive system. It is going to have the 2.5-inch Fox live valve shocks. It's basically going to be a baby Raptor, which we are absolutely beside ourselves about. They've been throwing this Raptor name at a bunch of different trims. You have the Bronco, you have the F-150 now, and now you have this. We did do a video a little bit while back where they're considering putting the Raptor name on a Mustang. So you know what? We're here for it. Put it on everything. Put it on an Explorer. Put it on a Focus. Bring the Focus back. Put it on a Focus. There's tons of different options, and people really seem to be having fun with it. So let us know down in the comments what you think about a Ranger Raptor. Is it going to do well here? I think it will do well here because, you know, you go 30 minutes to the west and you are in some of the most ridiculous off-road country that you can find. Looks like they have the Raptor branded bucket seats, trying saying that, 5 times really fast. They also have that red cross stitch on the top of the steering wheel, which is now become a staple in Raptor vehicles. So we think that this is fantastic. I'm very excited to see what else that they do with this vehicle going forward. The nice thing about Raptors is that they're so well optioned as well. So like, not only do you get the performance, but you also get, you know, the Bang & Olufsen sound system. You get the 12.4-inch Sync 4 system. Like, everything is going to be very usable, very utilitarian, as well as very comfortable, as well as off-road capable, like which is the Raptor brand. So we're very excited to see that here. And in classic Ford fashion, they did actually have a pre-production 2023 Ranger Raptor win the stock mid-class category of the Baja 1000, completing the course in 26 hours and 21 minutes, which, if you know anything about off-road racing, that is a very difficult race to complete. So the fact that Ford just keeps coming out with these off-road vehicles and then sneaking them into these classes and then letting them kind of go, it's basically like more proving testing grounds, but they also that way are getting pedigree off of this by winning these races and showing it off that it's capable of doing these things. Let us know what you think, and yeah, pretty cool. In other news, Ford has promised more trim levels for the Bronco in the future. There was talks a little while back where Ford was going to have Bronco kind of branch off and be its own brand, where they would have, you know, brand-specific dealerships, like Bronco-branded dealerships. I don't know if that ever actually is going to come to fruition. However, it would be neat to see something like that. But again, kind of unnecessary the way that car sales are going right now. But yeah, more Bronco trims. What would you guys like to see out of a Bronco trim? Is there anything specific that they haven't done yet that you'd love to see? Obviously, they have the Performance. They have, you know, the Everglades that has the snorkel and the winch. They have, you know, the Wild Track, which is basically meant for off-roading. So if there's anything, I mean, personally, I'd like to see a Street Bronco. I would love to see a Street Bronco. I think that a lot of off-road people, or a lot of people would be perceptive to a trim level that is kind of more like low profile tires, a little bit lower to the ground. On a Bronco, I think that would look unreal. Let us know in the comments if you think that we should make one here at Campfire Ford. Because I think we should. And along with, obviously, those new trim level Broncos, Ford has just released something called the Bronco Trail app. It's actually an app where you can go into and it basically maps out where you've been off-road, and then you can share that with your friends. So if you found a really cool trail, or if you've made a really cool trail or something like that, you can basically map it out on this app, and then you can send it to your friends and they can go out and they can do the trail that you just did, which is really neat, actually. It's like a GPS tracking thing, so interesting to see what people come up with there. Spelling things out, probably inappropriate things. Doesn't matter. Still excited to see it. All right, now finally, it looks like GM, General Motors, is dropping Android Auto and CarPlay from their vehicles for something in-house made, something very specific to them. Now, Ford has basically said, no, we're gonna continue with that. I think personally, having Android Auto and Apple CarPlay in a vehicle is super beneficial, because these days, the way that things are going is that manufacturers are saying, hey, you want navigation in your car, that's totally fine, but there is now going to be a monthly subscription if you want that. So you get, it's like Sirius, you know, everyone was so excited to get Sirius for the first 3 months or whatever, and then afterwards you're like, I'm not paying for that. But now it's the same thing with navigation. So if you want navigation in a vehicle, they'll let you, give you 3 months free, and then it's subscription based after that. So going forward, I think Android Auto, Apple CarPlay, I don't know if GM is planning on doing something that's similar to that, where you can plug your phone in and it's up on screen, but if not, then I think that that's a big mistake, because you can have everything right at your fingertips on the screen. It makes everything a lot easier. You know, you don't need navigation in your car anymore, because you can have, you know, everybody has unlimited data plans these days, so you just throw it up on the screen and then you have it ready to go right there. So let us know if you think that that is a mistake. Let us know if you think that they're gonna make something that's, you know, potentially gonna rival those things, like an in-house designed one. Yeah, other than that, great week this week for Ford news. Obviously, we have this new Ranger we're very excited about, but remember to like and subscribe. We're going to be doing this constantly going forward. We might even add more people to the show and have people, you know, back and forth talks and everything like that. So let us know what you'd like to see on here. Other than that, we will see you next week. Thank you for watching.